Maybe have the next question from the brother in the rear.
Assalamu alaikum, sir. My name is S.K. Ranjanani, Deputy Engineer, Government of Maharashtra Water Supply Department. मैं नॉन इस्लामिक हूँ. मेरे क्वेश्चंस आर व्हाई द रिलीजियंस आर क्रिएटेड इन द वर्ल्ड. व्हाई द नंबर ऑफ रिलीजियंस इन द वर्ल्ड. इसमें एक सेंटेंस लिखा है पीस टीवी के नीचे, पीस द सॉल्यूशन फॉर ह्यूमैनिटी. मेरा इसमें राय है कि पीस के लिए नॉलेज और विजडम चाहिए. थैंक्स सर.
ब्रदर आज द क्वेश्चन दैट व्हाई आर देयर सो मेनी रिलीजियंस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन एंड आफ्टर दैट ही मेड अ कमेंट दैट Peace, the solution for humanity, the tagline of Peace TV. For peace, you require knowledge and wisdom. And I do agree with you. As far as the first part of the question is concerned, that why are there so many religions? If you realize that Almighty God, our Creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has sent only one religion. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 19, Inna deena indallahi al-Islam. The only religion, the only way of life acceptable in the sight of God is submitting our will to God. The Almighty God only sent on one religion. And all the messengers that came, right from Adam, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, Muhammad, peace be upon them all of them taught nothing but submitting your will to Almighty God. Now in Arabic, when a person submits his will to Almighty God, he is called as a Muslim. And the religion of Islam comes from the root word salam, which means peace. It's also derived from the Arabic word silm, which means to submit your will to Almighty God. So Islam in short means peace acquired by submitting your will to Almighty God. So Almighty God, our Creator, got only one religion, but by the passage of time, the scriptures kept on getting changed. There was interpolation, there was fabrication, and whenever the scriptures kept on changing, as Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 79, فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَخْتُبُونَ الْكِتَابَ بِأَيْدِيهِمْ ثُمَّ يَقُولُونَ هَذَا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ لِيَشْتَرُوا بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا فَوَيْلٌ لَّهُمْ مِمَّا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَوَيْلٌ لَّهُمْ مِمَّا يَكْسِبُونَ. Woe to those who write the book with their own hands and then say this is from Allah, to traffic with it for a miserable price. Woe to those for what they write, woe to those for what they earn. Now whenever Almighty God sent a revelation, sent an instruction manual, in the passage of time, the instruction manual, the revelation of Almighty God changed. Now when the message got corrupted, Almighty God sent a new messenger and a new message. This kept on happening until Almighty God sent the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and last and final message, that is the glorious Quran. All the messengers that came previously, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Almighty God sent 124,000 messengers on the face of the earth. By name, only 25 are mentioned in the Quran. The others, we don't know. Maybe someone asked me that, can you consider, you coming from a Hindu background, if you ask me, can you consider Ram as a messenger of God, or can you consider Shri Krishna to be the messenger of God? I say, since his name is not mentioned in the Quran or the Hadith, I don't know. Maybe he was, maybe he was not. I cannot say for sure. But the point to be noted, all the messengers that came before Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, they were only sent for those people at that time. So even if Ram was a messenger of God, even if Krishna was a messenger of God, he was sent for those people at that time. Today, all the human beings, irrespective whether they live in India or in America or Saudi Arabia or Canada or UK, any part of the world, they should follow the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and last and final message, that is the glorious Quran. And Allah has taken a promise in Surah Hijr, chapter number 15, verse number 9, that we have revealed the Quran and we shall guard it from corruption. So Almighty God sent only one religion, that is submitting your will to God. Islam means peace acquired by submitting your will to God. And you said peace can be acquired by knowledge and wisdom. Yes, Knowledge from whom? The best you do. Is Almighty God our creator. Who is the most wise? Al-Hakim. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty God. So the best peace can be given to you is by following the knowledge and guidance of our creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you.